So in the last class, we are discussing the problem that is a rod whose diameter is 40 mm and length is 4 meters is bored at the center, that is making a hole at the center whose diameter is 20 mm. And we need to find out the length. We need to find out the length of the rod that is bored. So in this problem, we need to divide into two parts. First one is unbored position. Unbored, that is without hole. Without a hole, the solid shaft. Without hole, the solid shaft. And we need to find out the elongation for that case one. This is case one. We need to find out the elongation for the solid shaft for the case one. And the second case, we have a hole whose depth of the hole is unknown. So we need to find out the depth of the hole. So first case, in the first case, we need to find out the elongation. So here the elongation of the rod can be found by using the formula F into L by E into A, where F value is given, that is load applied on the rod is given, and length of the solid rod is given, that is 4 meters, and he had given the diameter of the solid rod, which is 40 mm. Therefore, I can find the area. And Young's modulus of that material, is given 2×10⁵ Newton per mm square. Substituting all the values in my equation, I can find the elongation of the solid body, that is the case one. Solid body, that is nothing but a case one amma, without any bore. So we need to find out the delta L of this solid body. This is the case one is completed. We need to find out the delta L by substituting all the values in my equation. Find out the delta L. Next, case two. Here, the case two is having a hole at the center whose diameter is small d. The value of the diameter small d is 20 mm. He had given this small d as 20 mm. Therefore, here two types of cross sections are available. First one is a solid, second one is hollow shaft. Two different cross sections are available. So we need to separately find the delta L for the solid for the case two and delta L for the hollow for the case two. And what is the load acting on this component? He is telling the same load the same load is acting on this component. Therefore, I need to divide the load for the solid and for the hollow. I need to divide the load for the solid and for the hollow. If I considering the load for the solid, I need to see that the solid part must be in equilibrium. Therefore, the same load need to be considered on the opposite side. Therefore, I am considering the same load on the opposite side for the solid. Therefore, I consider this in this part. Therefore, the remaining is again a P for the hollow. So if you see the hollow part, if you see the hollow part, it is also in equilibrium condition. It is also in equilibrium condition. Therefore, I can apply the equations. I can apply the equations delta L. I can apply the equations delta L for the solid separately and for the hollow separately. So I am considering the hollow section now. I am considering the hollow section. The load here is P again. And what is the area? If you see the area, cross-sectional area, the outer diameter is capital D, which is equal to 40 mm. The inner diameter, that is small d, which is 20 mm. Therefore, the cross-sectional area of the hollow cylinder is pi by 4 capital D square minus pi by 4 small d square. So which is equal to pi by 4 40 square minus 20 square. So we will get the area of hollow section in mm square. So we can substitute here in the formula. That is, I need to find out the delta L for the hollow section. The load is similar load, ama P is nothing but 4 kilonewtons or 40 kilonewtons, whatever he had given. And next, L. Here L, what is the L, ama? We need to find out the L. Therefore, I need to write it as F into X is the L here, ama. And the area of the hollow section, the area of the hollow section and Young's modulus. This is the delta L for the hollow section. This is the delta L for the hollow section. Next, in this problem, we have a solid also. In this case, we have solid also. So how to find the solid now? Delta L for the solid. The same formula is also applied for here also. And the forces on the solid portion is again P. The solid on the solid portion, the forces are again P. And the length of the solid cross section is L minus X here. The length here is L minus X. The remaining length is L minus X. And what is the area? Here the area is, it is nothing but capital D M R. Therefore, 40 square. So it will be in mm square. It will be mm square. Therefore, I can substitute all the values in my standard equation delta L. And I can find the delta L hollow. Delta L hollow is equal to F into, here L is L minus X, length of the solid particle is L minus X, and area of the solid into Young's modulus. This is the formula for the, this is the formula for the solid portion. Now I need the total elongation of the case 2. The total elongation of the case 2 is nothing but delta L of case 2. The total. So it is nothing but solid part elongation plus hollow part elongation. In the problem, he had given some relation. He had given some relation, that is, the elongation after the boring, that is after making a hole is increased by 30%. It is increased by 30%. Initially, whatever the elongation is there, that will be presented. And it is increased by 30%. Therefore, initially it is 1 elongation and it is increased by 30% is 0.3. Therefore, we will get 1.3 is the now elongation for the case 2. Therefore, initially, what is the elongation for the case 1? We need to find out. We have found it by using the formula. And we need to multiply the previous value with 1.3 to get the total elongation in the case 2. Total elongation in the case 2. Which is also equal to the case 2, that is nothing but solid and hollow. Therefore, delta L of the solid plus delta L of the hollow. So I can make a common, that is the forces are equal on the both cases. The forces are equal on the both cases and the Young's modulus are equal for the both cases. Therefore, I can make a common and the equation becomes in terms of L minus X by AS plus L minus X by AH. Therefore, L is also known value, that is 4 meters. So 4,000, I can write it as L as 4,000. Therefore, F is known value and a Young's modulus is known value. AS, that is solid area, is known value and hollow area is known value. And this is also known value, ma, because we have from the case 1, we have found this value. Therefore, this is also known value. Therefore, here unknown is only X. Here unknown is only X. Find the unknown of X in mm. Then convert this in meters. This is the answer for the problem. So answer may be in terms of 3.2 meters. So do the problem and find the answer. It may be 3.2 nearly. 3.2 meters. So with this, I am concluding the varying cross sections. So next topic is very, very, very important topic, Amma. The elongation in a cone. When external uniaxial load is applied on the body. So up to now, we have studied the uniform cross-sectional areas. But in this derivation, we will study the varying cross-section areas. In this side, the diameter is bigger amma, capital D. In this side, the diameter is smaller, small d. And the load is acting along the uniaxial. The load is acting uniaxial and the elongation of the component will be occur. The elongation of the component will be occur. We need to find out the what is the elongation for that component. So this is a derivation amma. This is the derivation for a tapered body, or we'll call it as a tapered rod. Tapered rod. We'll call it as a cone or tapered rod. Tapered rod amma. So deriving this. So we have a cone and whose diameter is capital D. Whose diameter is capital D and whose minor diameter is small d. This is capital D and this is small d. And the length of the cone is L. Length of the cone is L. Length of the cone is L. And we can find the diameters to find the height. So here on the both sides we have the same value, capital D minus small d by 2. So here the small d is removed from the capital D. The remaining will be capital D minus small d by will be remaining on both sides. It is equally distributed on the axis. Therefore, the distance here will be capital D minus small d by 2. And I need to consider an elemental step. I need to consider an elemental step at a distance of x. At a distance of x, the elemental stick's distance is x and its thickness is dx. And its thickness is dx. So here, I need to find out the diameter of the elemental stick. I need to find out the diameter of the elemental stick. Diameter of the elemental stick. So here, the elemental stick, if you see the elemental stick, this diameter I know that it is d, small d. This diameter I know that it is a small d. But I don't know this damn height. I don't know this height. Therefore, the diameter of the strip is nothing but small d plus 2 times of y. I need the y. I need the y to find the diameter of the stick. So to find this, I am considering the top triangle. I am considering the top triangle. And the height of the triangle is, the height of the triangle is capital D minus small d by 2. And the length of the triangle is, that is nothing but a base, is L. If I consider up to this tip only, if I consider up to this tip only, the base is X, the base is X, and the height will be Y. The height of the tip will be Y. Therefore, I am considering a similar triangles here, amma. I am considering a similar triangles considering a angle of theta. Therefore, tan theta for the bigger triangle, opposite side is capital D minus small d by 2. And adjacent side for the big triangle is L. And similarly for the small triangle, the opposite side is Y and the adjacent side is X. This is the bigger triangle, this is the small triangle. Therefore, here the angle are same for the both. The angle is same for the both. Therefore, I can take it as tan theta is equal to capital D minus small d by 2 L must be equal to Y by X. Where y is equal to, I can find now y is equal to capital D minus small d by 2L into X in terms of X. So I have found the Y. Now substituting in my equation, diameter of the strip is equal to small d plus 2y. Therefore, substituting in my equation, 2 will be cancelled. We will get small d plus capital D minus small d by L into X. This is the diameter of the strip. Now I am considering only strip. The load acting on the strip. The load acting on the strip is again P, external load. And the length of the strip is dx. Therefore, I need to find out the elongation in this strip. In small elemental strip, I need to find out the elongation. So here, we know the equation. The elongation of a component. Initially, if you see the diagram, it will be somewhat taper. This elemental strip will be somewhat taper in the ends. But it is small length, I can consider it as horizontal. Therefore, I need to find out the elongation in this strip. Therefore, the load acting on the strip, is again P, and the length of the strip is dx, and the area of the strip, the formula is again same amount. For area of the strip is pi by 4. It is a circular part. Therefore, pi by 4 d S square and Young's modulus of that material. Therefore, where ds is equal to, we have found it as in terms of x, small d plus capital D minus small d by L into x, where I am assuming it as k, capital D minus small d by L as k. Therefore, ds is equal to small d plus k into x. Therefore, I am substituting all the values. This is the elongation in this strip due to the external load. If I need the elongation in the total rod, I need to do an integral, and the limits is 0 to L, because the length is varying, dx is varying from x is equal to 0 to L. So I am applying the small elemental step elongation and its integral, and x is equal to 0 to x is equal to L, up to L. So this is the, to get the elongation in the total rod. So here P and capital E are constants. So I am removing out from the, integral. Therefore 4P pi pi E integral 0 to L and dx small d plus k into x whole square. So it looks like 1 by x square, integral 1 by x square. So I can write it as 1 by minus x. 1 by minus x. We know the formula x to the power of n, which is nothing but integral x to the power of n is nothing but x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1 plus c. So here minus 2 means minus 2, n is a minus 2, therefore minus 2 plus 1, it gives a minus 1, therefore again it becomes a denominator. And here a constant, minus 2 plus 1 becomes again minus 1. I'm taking out that minus 1, I'm taking out. And here in front of x we have a k, so we need to differentiate it with the x also, therefore we'll get a constant k. So k is also a numerical constant because it is not varying with x. Therefore, I can remove out. Now, I need to apply the limits. After integral, I need to apply the limits. X is equal to 0 and x is equal to L. So, applying the limits. So, 1 by small d plus k into L. In x place I am applying L and x place I am applying 0 and making a minus. We are applying the upper limit and the lower limit of the integrals. So we will get this type of equation. After this, we are substituting k value. We are substituting the k value, that is capital D minus small d by L. Capital D minus small d by L. Therefore, here we have a k. Therefore, I am substituting capital D minus small d by L. It is moved upward direction. And next, I am substituting here. It is also k is available. Therefore, I am substituting here. And L will be cancelled. L will be cancelled. And next. So here small d, a positive small d and a minus small d is available in the numerators. Therefore, they will be cancelled. One is a positive, another is a negative. Therefore, it will be cancelled. Therefore, we will get a capital D. So we need to take a LCM for this. Therefore, capital D into small d, and we'll get a capital D minus small d. This small d minus capital D. So if you see here, this and this, if you multiply with the minus, we'll get a capital D minus small d. Therefore, both will be cancelled. The answer, the final answer for the tapered rod is 4P into L by pi E capital D into small d. Is the elongation that can be found for a tapered rod when an uniaxial load is applied on the component. That is only one dimensional load. Sir, if the rod is a cylindrical, it is not a tapered, how to find the formula? Instead of capital D, I can substitute this small d because it is a cylindrical part now. Instead of capital D, I can substitute this small d. Therefore, I will get in an equation that is, P into L by pi by 4 d square into E, which is equal to P into L by area into Young's modulus. This is the delta L for a cylindrical part. So I can derive, the elongation of a cylindrical part by a similar manner while considering for a cone or a tapered part. It is a very important derivation, Amma. It is a very important derivation. You need to practice it. Next, any doubts in this derivation? So the main dot will be only this part, Amma. How to find the y? This is the main doubt. If you clarify this, you can solve all the remaining parts. So next derivation is a rectangular tapered body. And we need to find out the elongation in this component when an external load is applied on the component. Whose thickness is same, Amma? That is the thickness at this region and the thickness at this region are same. But the width only different. Here the width is different. And here the width is different. The width of the are different along the length. Hello, any doubts? Emma, any doubts on Techa Aragandi? When name Mali explain Yasano? You can unmute or you can make a chart. In a chart, you can explain me. Any doubts? So here the thickness of the component is a uniform thickness, but the width, the width is capital B and here the width is small b. The width is varying along the length. The width is varying along the length. A similar process need to be considered here also, ma. A similar process need to be considered here also. Here it is a small b. Here it will be a capital B. And what is the height here? It is similar, ma. Capital B minus small b divided by 2. The remaining width is distributed on the both sides. The remaining width will be distributed on the both sides. So here I need the width of the strip. Width of the strip. So to this, again a similar process. I need to consider a triangle. I need to find out the height of the triangle. I need to find out the y. This is the y. Both sides will have a y. And this is a b, small b. This will be small b. The strip will thickness will be constant amount. Strip thickness will be constant. So how to find the y? Again a similar process. Y is equal to capital B minus small b by 2 L into X. Similar triangle. From the similar triangle, I can find the Y. Next, I need to find out the width of the strip. Width of the strip is nothing but small b plus 2y. Both sides we have a 2y and y. Therefore, we'll get small b plus, substituting the y value, and 2 will be cancelled. We'll get the width of the strip is nothing but small b plus capital B minus small b by L into X. Emma, 315, any problem? 315. Now I need to consider the only strip area. I need to consider only strip area, and I need to find out the elongation in the strip, and what is the load acting on the strip and its length. The length of the strip is again dx, and the load acting on the strip is again p, and I need to find out the elongation in the strip. The formula is load into the length is nothing but delta x by area of the strip. How to find the area of the strip? So it looks like a rectangle. The width is bs and the depth is t. therefore area of the strip is bs into t, bs into t. N with Young's modulus, N with Young's modulus. Next, substituting BS value, in terms of K, substituting the BS value in terms of K. So I can take it as P into dx divided by small b plus k into x into t into capital E. This is the elongation, in the strip. If I need the total elongation in this rod, if I need the total elongation in the rod, I need to do the integral. And the limits are 0 to L. So how to find the total elongation in the rod? I have found the elongation in the strip. So the elongation in the strip is equal to so here if you see this, P, T and E are constant. Therefore, I can remove from the integrals. And it looks like 1 by x, integral of 1 by x. What is the value of integral 1 by x? It is log e x. Therefore, I can write it as and here a constant k will be coming out among. So substituting the upper limit and lower limit for the h, Substituting the upper limit and lower limit for h. That is x is equal to L and x is equal to 0. Now substituting the k value, we know that k value is, we know that k value is capital B minus small b by L. So here we will get log capital B minus log E small b. Therefore, here a logarithm function is available, log A minus log B. I can write it as so this is the final equation for the tapered rod. This is the final equation for the tapered rectangular rod with uniform thickness. Uniform thickness. So any doubt on these two derivations? Amma, evarikana doubt unnaya? Otherwise, I am closing my section. So with this, I am concluding the elongations part. When an uniaxial load is applied on the component, so I have derived a uniform cross-sectional areas, and I have derived for the varying cross-sectional areas, I had derived the uniformly varying cross-sectional areas. So I am ending my section, Amma.